Studio to discuss this is a global affairs analyst, Ejike. Thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you for having me on your show.
All right, it's World Press Freedom Day. Of course, it is marked on the 3rd of May every year. But do you feel that as a member of the press, you're free to do your job?
Well, let me give you some clarification. I'm not a member of the press, but I'm somebody who subscribes to freedom of the press. Because with the freedom of the press, you have the ability, you know, for people to be informed about whatever their government is doing. And when you don't have that, then people are in the dark, and it has a tendency to create tension, especially in the Nigerian situation, where certain things, if you say it, you know, you become an enemy of the state or enemy of whatever things that information you're getting out is not necessary. So, you know, freedom of the press has to be encouraged and constitutionally entrenched. So that way people can be informed about their government. You know, back in the 70s, in fact, one of the things that brought down the Gowon regime that time was the, you know, the corruption issue between, you know, Godwin Dabo and Joseph Taka, which became, if you Dabo me, I Taka you. So, but now, since then, if you see Nigerian press back in the 70s, after the war, was considered one of the fairest in the world. But now, you know, based on what has happened to journalists, and then the inability of NUJ to fight for journalists. So the press has been suppressed. So the freedom of press in Nigeria is really, really limited. And that's why you have the issues going on and the inability of the people to respond to things that the government do that doesn't benefit them.
What has been the limitation so far, the main obstacles to press freedom?
The main obstacle is you don't have a judicial recourse. So if a journalist, for whatever reason, is unduly attacked by the establishment because of publishing or sharing information that would benefit the people, what happens is then, you know, the NUJ or the, you know, the employer of the journalist doesn't do anything to defend them. And so that's one of the biggest things. So there's this fear factor that exists among journalists. Even if the information is accurate, I'm talking about accurate information that is needed. I'm not talking about sensational stuff. Things that have been properly investigated, things that are necessary to inform the Nigerians about what is going on. So that's the biggest thing. We have to, Nigerians have to deal with their elected officials to make sure that when information that is put out there and somebody is uncomfortable about it, then they have to go to court or prove that it's not the case.
How do we handle disinformation?
Well, the disinformation, first of all, you have to do the investigation. It has to be factual, and that's why, you know, how much of the journalism or the ethics are investigative? And what are the guidelines? So who says those ethics? Is it the employer of the journalist or the journalist himself or herself? And so the standard has to be there, because except the standard is set and agreed to by everybody, then, you know, it becomes a matter of discretion. You know, if it doesn't suit me, then I'm going to react to it differently.
What standards are acceptable to everybody?
Well, it can be, assembly is that when the information is put out, the editor or the producer, like in your situation, you know, in your studio, when you put out that information, some staff member would have verified that it's authentic. And so when it's out there, then it's out there. And you cannot be penalized for getting that information out. So it has to come from the employer, it has to come from a professional standard. As I said, the NUJ should be more proactive, and they should be out there to defend the journalist. In fact, sometimes when information is being suppressed, they should sue on behalf of, for instance, the TVC or Channel News, whomever, to protect the integrity of the profession, and go to court, and they should also participate in sponsoring legislation, both at the state and at the federal level, to make sure that when these things are done, that if for whatever reason any personality feels that they are being on targeted, then they're standing for the journalist.
Okay, so in all of this, now I had a discussion with a journalist earlier in the news, and he spoke about the fact that new media has been a contributory factor to lack of freedom of the press.
Are you talking about the social media part of it? I mean, technology has enabled everybody to be a journalist because you can go to any platform and upload. But we're talking about something that has to do with a governor, a senator, somebody whose role in public service impacts in some kind of way the perception of the country. So that's what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about people getting feeling good and posting anything on Facebook.
But that's what we see every time when information comes, people just post without verifying.
Well, they're not professional. So you can't supervise them, you can't regulate them. But if for whatever reason that is, you know, because this has no, what is it called? No smoke without fire. So, if it's something that is gathering sensation, then, you know, the media people will look into it. And if it makes sense, then they add credibility to it. Or they say, that's just one of those.
All right.
So that's what it is. But in the case of Nigeria literally needs to allow information to flow out. At the same time, make it possible for the market woman. You know, I visit the country and people don't even know what's going on. Because, you know, information is out there, but how do they get it? Do they get it by their phone? Do they buy the papers? The papers are very expensive for people to do. A lot of them don't have radio or TV. So you are here sharing information, but what is the audience? What is the listening audience of that information?
All right, Global Affairs Analyst Ejike Okpa, thank you so much for talking to us.
Well, thank you for having me. Your studio, I'm glad that I'm in the country and get to meet you guys live.
Thank you very much.